Jai Siddhama, everyone. This is Sadhvi Siddhali Shree here with my spiritual teacher and guru, Acharya Shree Yogeesh, for the 11th episode of Acharya Shree's podcast. Acharya Shree is a respected enlightened one who has helped thousands of souls progress on their spiritual path and totally transform. Welcome to all of our new listeners, and thank you for tuning in. Matham Vanami, Acharya Shree. Acharya Shree, in our last episode, we were talking about the Tirthankars and your you shared your experience learning under Tirthankar Parshvanath. So that leads to the question of what happens after enlightenment? What is liberation? What is moksha? And what is Siddha?
Yeah, the Siddha is a special word in Indian culture and especially in the Samanic tradition. Siddha is a asharira. Asharira means no body, bodiless. When you become Tirthankar, Arihanta, enlightened one, they carrying their last body. And the last body has to end, because that is the, I mentioned earlier, that the body is the result of the karma. We carrying good body or bad body, sick body or healthy body. So if it is healthy body and person is leaning towards spirituality, can use this body to grow. It's a blessing. That it is a healthy body. So the when enlightenment happens, enlightenment is like a blissful state. Even they are in their last body, they are feeling or they are having the same bliss like God has it. And God, as I mentioned, is not a person. That's what I mentioned in the beginning. Siddha means asarira, bodiless. God is bodiless. We call it nirakar. Nirakar, akar means shape, nirakar means no shape. Siddha is a shapeless, bodiless, formless, and timeless. Time doesn't affect Siddha. And what is Siddha? When the last body comes to the end, last breath of the in the body, and it has to go somewhere. As soon as the soul leaves the last body, soul is already lighted, and light thing flow upward. Any light thing, you should, like one little balloon, you release it, it is going to go upward. Smoke, going to go upward. It doesn't go downward, it goes upward, because this is light. If you have seen the butter, butter is very light. It will float into the water or into the lassi, because it is a lighter. The nature of the lighter things to go upward. And soul doesn't have any other purpose, because whatever supposed to achieve it got achieved. Bliss is the last thing, and bliss is always eternal. Once you achieve it, it stays with you forever. It is actually with you already. It is just a matter of realizing it, or experience it, or feeling it. We don't do it, we don't realize it, that the bliss was always with us. It is just our illusion, our blockages is blocking not to feel it. They feel once in a while. That's what I mentioned. The bliss is like a Brahmanand Sahodara. Brahmanand Sahodara means like is the brother of the Brahma. Brahma means God. It is the nature of the God, nature of the enlightened soul, the bliss. Bliss is a very powerful thing. It is eternal, and bliss is always new. It is not like when you are happy, your happiness stays the same. No, bliss changes in every moment. Every moment is new. And no matter how forever, infinite, every moment is newer, newer, newer. So it is not a boring. Bliss is not a boring. It is always new. Because I have seen people who are very rich, they get bored after a while. Money doesn't mean to them anymore. They get bored. They want to do something new. But bliss is every single moment is newer. That's why in Siddhahood, the soul which goes upward, where it stops, that question arises. That's what people need to know. This whole universe is divided into two. One is called loka, one is called aloka. Loka, but these both are universe. Loka has two things, dharmasthikaya, adharmasthikaya. Dharmasthikaya is a matter which helps us to move. Like the water helps to move a fish. Fish, no water, fish doesn't move. It moves because water helps to move. Same way there, this whole loka, whole universe, is filled up with two things. It dharmasthikaya, the matter, material, which helps us to move. And one is opposite, adharmasthikaya, which helps us to stop. Whenever we want to stop, we can stop. Whenever we want to walk, we can walk. If it is lacking, these two elements, or substance is the best word to use it. These substance, if they are lacking, you cannot move anything. That is aloka. Mm-hmm. Aloka doesn't have this. Neither dharmasthikaya, neither adharmasthikaya. You cannot have movement there, no walking, no activity. You cannot enter. Suppose loka, this seems like a space. You can see further, but it becomes a wall. You cannot fall down other side. Even it seems like empty space, like a sky. But because there is no two substances there, neither to move in, neither to move, like to stop it. So it is lacking, so then it becomes a wall. So that is called aloka. Aloka is all around the loka. So when the soul is free, because the karma is the heaviest thing, now it is karmaless. Siddha means the soul which is free from all eight karmas. Eight karmas are main karmas. And when it is fully free, all their karmic body, tejas body, they are fully empty. So soul is under 100% free. And free soul begin to move upward. And it keep going, keep going, keep going, till aloka is touched, the highest part. So we call that space, they cannot move further, the soul cannot go further. That is called Siddha Loka, or the place where God lives. We call it Siddha Loka, where all these free souls, they go and they are in the bliss. Like God is in the bliss, always in the bliss. So the thing you have to understand, or the people have to understand, Siddha is fully free soul We call it liberation. We call it nirvana. We call it parinirvana. We call it mukti. We call it moksha. So there are a few words. Moksha means you released, liberated. So once you liberated, but people don't understand where they have to liberate from, which things. The best thing is to understand the karma. Karma concept, if person knows it, karma is the one who is making you suffer, making you, keeping you in this as world of suffering. So once karma is free, all your inner bodies are astral body, tejas body, karmic body, they are totally empty, no information in it. So everything is deleted. Soul become free and it begin to go upward. If person's pose is sitting in meditative state, the enlightened person, and it is time to be full liberation. So the soul will reach to the Siddha Loka first, body will fall down later. It takes only that much time to reach there. But it has to be total freedom. And total freedom doesn't happen. It happens in the last moment. Everything has to finish. All karma has to finish. All heaviness has to gone. And soul is free. Free soul, we call it Siddha. And Siddha is a totally karmaless. That's what I mentioned one time. Yeah, you can divide into two. Jivatma, Paramatma. Jivatma is still wandering in this world of suffering. It is with karma. So jiva means with karma. And Paramatma means just absolute soul. Nothing else. Purest soul. No heaviness, no karma with it. So Siddha is a special concept. Is it not a concept? It is a reality. The God is the purest one. And Siddha means God. God is always total freedom. And if somebody want to taste really, really, real freedom, they have to achieve the Siddhahood. What we think, oh, we live in the free country, we live in democracy. That is not a democracy. Democracy is when you are 100% free from karma. That is called total freedom. So the Siddha Siddhahood is very difficult to achieve. It needs a lot of practices, sadhana, spiritual practices, meditation, tapa, japa. There are many ways to achieve that state. And whoever achieve it, once it is achieved, they are always into bliss, total freedom. That's what I call them, Siddha.
Acharya Shree, so to confirm, even a Tirthankara, an Arihant, an enlightened person, still has karma. They are not liberated yet.
No, not fully liberated yet. Till the body is there, as I mentioned, body is the result of karma. And till it is alive, karma will remain. But those four karmas out of eight, they are not as strong. Mm-hmm. Like Vedaniya karma, stay till the end of the last breath. Vedaniya means you feel sukha and dukkha. You feel pleasant and unpleasant. You feel comfortable, uncomfortable. You feel like pain, suffering. Till body is there, it is the nature of the body. That is the result of the karma. So those Vedaniya karma goes, it totally let you free the soul in that last moment. And there are another karmas like name, nam karma. Their name will be there. After becoming Siddha, there is no name. It's nameless.
All the Siddhas are nameless.
Nameless.
No identity.
No identity. Mm. That's what I used to say. I wrote one poetry one time. I was sitting in this, maybe Siddha mode that time. That chalo chale ab paar gagan se, let's go cross to this all space, the loka. Jaha basera bin tan man se, where you reside, your home, if there is no tan, means body, there no mind, there is just pure soul. So that is called Siddha Loka. And this poetry, this poem, was published by all magazines in India. And that is the real our goal supposed to be. Supposed to be our goal, that we want total freedom. And total freedom cannot be achieved unless you become Siddha.
Acharya Shree, I would think in meditation sometimes fear comes up because you're losing your identity, your thoughts, you're disconnecting from these things. When a soul becomes liberated, do they still retain their individuality or they've fully merged with the ocean?
That is the beauty of Siddha Loka. Siddha Loka doesn't take your individuality away. All Siddhas are individual, even they are nameless. But their existence remains individual. That's why the Samanic tradition, which is the oldest one in India or in the world, they always tell that if you want to experience the real democracy, what is democracy? That it doesn't finish your existence. You exist and they respect you. Same thing Siddha Loka. Even they become Siddha, even they merge with God, even they merge into the bliss, but their existence remains same, no matter what. Maybe the light is same. Like the, suppose in a big hall, there is a one candle. You light maybe 100 candle, 1,000 candle, 100,000 candle. Light merge with the light. But candle's existence remains separate. Same way in the Siddhahood or Siddha Loka, the soul's existence, individual soul's existence remain separate still. But their knowing, their existence, merging with God, light merge with the light, it becomes one. So, in a way, Siddha is one and Siddha is many. That's what in Namukar Mantra, we call it Namo Siddhanang. Actually, meaning Namo Siddhanang means I bow to God. But it is written in plural, Siddhanam. I bow to Siddhas. And the real meaning is God of Siddhanam. But it is written in plural. Why? Because their existence is still separate. Otherwise, what is the meaning of the free soul? It cannot enjoy the bliss. If merged with something, then and their existence is no more, they cannot enjoy the bliss. So the bliss is enjoyed by the every individual Siddha separately.
That's mind-blowing.
Okay.
Thank you, Acharya Shree. Acharya Shree, we have this concept of God. I was raised Catholic. You know, we Christians view God in one way. Hindus can see God another, Muslim, all these things. And usually they see God as a single form. And usually they pray to God. Because Siddha is God and it's plural. So when people pray to God or pray to Siddha, can God or Siddha as an individual help? or their idea of God is already incorrect, so their prayers don't count?
I think the most popular religion, they have little misconception about God. Hindus, Muslims, Jewish, Christian, they are in the same boat. But they think God is a person and is sitting in the heaven. Their approach is not more than heaven. No, just heaven. That heavenly father means he's a king. And if he has a, it is like a king, he has to be a person. And that's why they pray that the person or a king can take your miseries away. But can you believe if the Samnic tradition, somebody believes it, there are infinite Siddha. Can you believe? You say Namo Siddhana, they all help you. It's a mind-blowing.
Yeah, that's mind-blowing.
So I will suggest you to get the real concept of God. So instead of one person helps you, infinite souls helping you. That is the beauty of the Siddha. It's a plural. In a way it is one, but in a way it is many. So that's why if in people's minds the real concept of God, they can get help so much they cannot even believe. Just say Namo Siddhana. All Siddha at once, they will going to help you.
Acharya Shree, when we say Namo Siddhana, which means I bow to God or I bow to Siddha, I bow to liberated soul, that's a mantra, it's a prayer in itself. But you also say you cannot really pray to God in the sense communicate with God or communicate with Siddha because they don't have a body. So how does that work?
Yeah, that is sure. You cannot communicate with the God, with the Siddhas or liberated soul because they don't have any instrument left. Instrument was the body last and that is gone. So you cannot really communicate with the God. And that's why people are into the dark, that we talking to the God, many people think.
Mm-hmm.
If you're talking to the God, you're talking to the person. A person has a body and God doesn't have a body. God is nirakar, shapeless, bodiless, formless. How you will communicate? You can be in tune with the God. Like the sun is shining, you are sitting under the sun. Same way when you are in tune with the Siddha, that is called prayer. You have to be in tune with Siddha. Siddha will not tell you anything. Sun will not do anything for you. But you are under the sunshine. Same way. If somebody learn how to be in tune with Siddha, that is called prayer. But how? They have to forget their own identity. It is not that you will say words. God doesn't need your words. They need, if you are in tune with them. In tune, you can be in tune with the Siddha. Are shapeless, formless, doesn't need words. So in tuning is totally different than communicating. Communication is verbally, physically, and there is no verbally there, there is no physically. Siddha is a totally pure soul, shapeless. So you can be in tune with them. You just sit under them. Because Siddha Loka is on the top. And you are already sitting underneath.
Mm.
But you are not in tune because you are communicating with other stuff. With money, with relation, with friends, with family, with animals, with birds. That's what you can communicate with the whole universe. Whatever visible, it is easy. Whatever is visible, you can communicate. That's why if you want to really communicate with God, communicate with Arihanta, communicate with Tirthankara. That is available, always available. If you want to really communication And that's what I gave, the seed mantra for the how to communicate with Tirthankara. Ring, 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 ring. H-R-I-M. And little dot on the top. Ring. Ring is the sound which merges or communicates. You can talk with them. They are live God. Extraordinary soul. Last body. But you can communicate with them. But you can be in tune with Siddha. You can realize Siddha. Sitting under the sunshine, you can feel what does it do for you. And if you forget your own existence that time, prayer begins. Mm. That is the real prayer. And the real prayer happens for the Siddha. An infinite Siddha, infinite soul will going to help you.
So basically you have to lose yourself in order to gain the whole God.
That's what it is. When you write, you have to lose yourself fully. You have to just be dead from everywhere. Not dead like physical, I'm talking. Means when you lose yourself, it means you don't know where your body is. You totally just forgot it. Where your body is, maybe you are in tune then, just light, right? And you will realize that's why God or Siddhas are realization. Mm-hmm. Realization is a prayer. Prayer is not just words. People satisfy themselves because they are feeling pain inside and they want to ask God something else because they think God is going to help them, right? But it seems like they are very selfish people. Instead of putting efforts, they just go easy way that the God will take care of everything. Hey, first forget your existence. As soon as you forget your existence, you are in tune with Siddhas, with God.
Maybe, Acharya Shree, in the next episode, we can discuss non-attachment and being detached from the body. So this way we can dive deeper into soul and our own Godhood.
That will be the excellent.
So many more questions to come. Mathemanami Acharya Shree, and thank you so much. And thank you all again for tuning in to Acharya Shree's podcast today. Please be sure to subscribe to his podcast on iTunes and YouTube, as well as follow him on social media via Facebook and Instagram. This way you continue to receive guidance for your spiritual journey and perhaps achieve liberation.
Jai Siddhatma.
Jai Siddhatma.